Countries worldwide are actively embracing autonomous vehicles within their navies, showcasing a global trend in maritime operations. For example, in late 2022, 7 Ukrainian uncrewed surface vessels conducted a stealth attack on the Russian Black Sea fleet in Crimea. In response, several months later, Russia reportedly launched its own uncrewed vessel attack against a key bridge in Ukraine's Odesa region, in what is understood to be Moscow's first use of naval drones. China has also unveiled its own unmanned naval vessels, including a guided missile destroyer. These collective efforts undoubtedly highlight the widespread integration of autonomous vehicles in naval operations worldwide. Amidst this global trend towards autonomous naval vehicles, the United States Navy has recently taken delivery of a prototype vessel known as the USNS Apalachicola. With its ability to operate autonomously at sea for up to 30 days, the 100-meter vessel stands as the Navy's largest ever surface vessel with autonomous capability. So, let's explore the capabilities and implications of this significant addition to the U.S. Navy's fleet. The USNS Apalachicola is the 13th vessel of the Spearhead-class expeditionary fast transports. The Spearhead-class is a U.S. Navy-led shipbuilding program to develop a high-speed, shallow-draft vessel intended for rapid transit and deployment of conventional or special forces, equipment and supplies. The Apalachicola boasts a shallow hull design, enabling it to navigate in areas where other ships may struggle. With a maximum payload capacity of 544 metric tons, the vessel can accommodate human crew members or function as an uncrewed platform, anti-submarine weapons platform, radar, sensor craft, or drone mothership. Its versatile capabilities make it a valuable asset in naval operations. Manufactured by Austral, in partnership with L3 Harris and General Dynamics Mission Systems, the Apalachicola incorporates an advanced automated machinery control system. This system centralizes machinery operations, allowing for minimal crewing by streamlining tasks. The vessel can support V-22 Osprey flight operations and facilitate the launch and recovery of rigid inflatable boats. With a length of approximately 100 meters, a beam of 28.5 meters, and a draft of 3.8 meters, the Apalachicola can transport troops, military vehicles, and equipment, weighing up to 600 tons, over distances of up to 1,200 nautical miles. Powered by 4 MTU diesel engines, the Apalachicola achieves a maximum speed of 43 knots, although operational sailings at full load typically range around 35 knots. While the Apalachicola is a non-combatant ship operated by the Navy's Military Sealift Command, it does feature four mounts for Browning M2 12.7mm machine guns to provide limited self-defense capabilities against smaller surface and airborne threats. The successful delivery of the Apalachicola has raised questions about the integration of this capability into the U.S. Navy's fleet. The Navy doesn't have a clear plan for the deployment of unmanned vessels and intends to approach their integration into the fleet in a deliberate manner. The phased implementation will likely involve starting with minimally manned vessels and gradually transitioning to fully unmanned operations. The goal is to address command and control challenges and ensure engineering reliability before advancing further, according to the Navy's Naval Sea Systems Command. Although autonomous platforms seem to be shaping the future of warfare, concerns remain regarding the decision-making abilities of uncrewed ships and the practicality of maintenance without human presence. What do you think? Let's discuss in the comments section below. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more content.